Thank you, Leila, for your presentation. Now it is the turn of Dr. Alex Binetto, who will present his activity. He received very recently the PhD degree in Electrical, Electronics and Communications Engineering, and he will for sure present you his experience. Dr. Binetto, it is your turn. Thank you.
Good afternoon to everybody. I hope you can hear me clearly and you can see the slides in full screen mode. Thank you for this opportunity. I'm Alex Binetto. I'm trying to present my point of view about a PhD. I titled this brief speech as Navigating a PhD, and you will understand soon the reason why I chose this title. And I tried also to, let's say, squeeze all the experience I got in the last 5 years of my life, going in and out the academic world, basically. And I found that the best way was to provide a linear timeline of these experiences that I had. Basically, I got my master's degree in telecommunication engineering in 2015, and in information theory and signal processing application. After a 6-month internship in the European Organization for the Exploitation of Meteorological Satellites, that was basically a spin-off of the European Space Agency. And I discovered at that time that research was, the guideline of my professional life, so much that at the end of the degree, so when I got my master's degree, I decided to switch to work for a company. So in the end, I was not so convinced in doing research. But I kept this opportunity to working in a company to retrieve a lot of experience. And then by November 2016, I started my PhD scholarship with the Navigation Signal Analysis and Simulation Research Group, which is part of the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication. It is led by Professor Fabio Dovis in a sort of a joint cooperation with the LINCS, Istituto Superiore Mario Boella, which is a research institute located in the Cittadella. And I got my PhD last week, 1 week ago, actually. So now I'm kind of postdoc researcher. I have a grant to keep going on with the research on the topic I faced during my PhD. What about a PhD from my point of view? Basically, I would say that PhD is a kind of the journey of making science. And I tried also in this case to summarize the steps of doing a PhD, of making science, with these keywords and key verbs to, I would say, provide my point of view. It's not always the case that science, that research, brings you from a problem to its solution, to some results, solving some questions, basically. You have to jump forward and backward through these different steps during your PhD. And this is a suggestion from me, from my experience, to spend the right time for each of these key steps, because you will experience a lot of reading activities, trying to understand the literature, the state of the art. You need to spend a lot of time thinking about new ideas, retrieving ideas from other researchers, sharing ideas within your team. And you have also to try and test many things during your lab life, your life in laboratory, doing experiments, doing simulation, doing any kind of things related to your research. And in the end, you have to provide some, I would say, some product of this research that is basically part of the PhD duties. So you have to write publications, you have to publish your results, you have to publish your knowledge, and you could also provide some presentation, public speaking events, in order to share what you learned in the best way possible. What about the problem I addressed during my PhD? Basically, I am a researcher in global navigation satellite systems that are known also as GNSS. Probably the most of you knows GPS, but we are not speaking only about GPS. We try to solve for the position, velocity, and also time of a given receiver on the Earth's surface, trying to collect the signals, weak signals coming from 20,000 kilometers, from satellites orbiting the Earth at 20,000 kilometers, and transmitting this weak signal through the atmosphere. So you can imagine how difficult could be this problem, and you can also imagine that we would like to have a kind of precise point positioning like the picture you can see in this slide, but is not usually the case in real life. We can get some kind of cloud of points representing our position somewhere. And if we are lucky enough, the average of this point could be something similar to our position, but usually it is not. And we tried to investigate if there was some kind of new approaches to compensate for all these impairments. And probably, as you probably know, there are some solutions provided by additional sensors that are integrated almost everywhere in your smartphones, for instance, as you can see in the picture here in the slide. But since this was already the state of the art for most of the research concerning GNSS, we excluded this kind of contributions. And we tried to exploit two rising technologies. First of all, the high-speed, low-latency networks, like the upcoming 5G. I was waiting for that 5G at the beginning of the PhD. I'm still waiting for some simulation environment in which testing 5G, actually. And the new generation of mass-market GNSS receivers. So basically, what you call navigator, satellite navigator, that are within your smartphone nowadays. And we succeeded in demonstrating that this kind of cooperation among a set of networked GNSS receivers was profitable to improve both precision and accuracy, so basically positioning performance of this kind of technology of the global navigation satellite systems. And we addressed several assessments about this this research, both from that was the best way to explore the theoretical aspects, the simulation, and also the proof of concept that we reached in the end of my PhD. As Professor Grivet said before, you had a chance to travel a lot during the PhD. And in these 3 years, I had a chance to visit many, many different places in the world. And somehow the PhD journey is a kind of a world tour based on science, basically. You have the chance to speak, to have public speaking events almost everywhere, at conferences, international, national conferences. And you have also the chance to participate in many summer schools, as Leila said before, and also to take part in a different kind of events during your research activities. Among these events, I can mention basically three big family of activities that you can attend during your PhD. First of all, some public speaking events. And we had the chance to participate, to be invited by Google at Mountain View to explain our idea of cooperative positioning in mass market devices. So you can reach some kind of this kind of opportunities. And also to be a speaker of a TEDx, of a first TEDx speaker, TEDx events in Politecnico di Torino. And I also participated as a one of the player of the consortium in a European Space Agency project called ANSEL, in which we developed our proof of concept. And in the end, I was that lucky that my work deserved some prizes that that I got during the PhD, like the Galileo Masters, that is basically a competition organized by the European Space Agency. And we got a prize promoted by the Italian Space Agency about our work and my research work. So that's all from my perspective, and I'll open for questions in the end of this presentation. Thank you for your attention.